my name is Beth Hattie here from BoardGameGeek at SPIEL 2019. I'm sitting down with Mark Schuldong from Skelly Games, and you've brought us your title for 2019, which is Ambrosia.
Yes, excellent. Hello, Beth. Good to see you
here. Hello.
Right. Yes, Skelly Games is a new publisher. We are around 1.5, 2 years old. The second time we are in Essen, and we have our second and third release here. And we are proud to be here, and it's quite successful. It's a great fair. So, beside being a publisher doing our own games,
B-side.
Being a publisher, we also partner of Eagle Griffin Games for Germany. So we're supporting some other games as well. So the portfolio is growing. But this is the proud we have today, right? So I would like to introduce Ambrosia.
What are we trying to do in Ambrosia?
So what you have, you're a bee colony. We are very successful in collecting nectar, honey, and you meet to compete who is the best in collecting honey. So you have defined a meadow with a lot of flowers, and you meet together. So why don't we just have a quick start here?
Sure.
That's your color. So you start with 6 standard bees, and you have 9 bees with superpower, right? This is the exciting part. So you take your 6 bees, I give this to you.
Okay.
Put them on, use one of the bees with superpower. For example, this one can fly backward. Choose whatever you like, it's all described here.
All right, I'm gonna do that one.
That one, all right, this is the one which is the spy, right?
And he's got a little spy outfit.
It's a saboteur, right? You've chosen a good one, right, already. So you saboteur the others. So we've built up for 3, but just to show the principles, you can expand to 4 and you can scale it down for 2 as well. The principle of the game is we have eliminated dices, so you own your destiny, right? What you do, you have 7 bees all the time. You choose 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bees just to move. And if you go for 4, you move 4 flowers further. If you take 5, it's 5. So it's up to you. You do the thing. So if you just start that, I go, for example, for some 4, and just give you an idea, moving also 4.
I will do 1, 2, 3, 4.
The target is to distribute all of your bees on the meadow. As soon as you have single bees, because they can't move anymore, you collect the nectar, the honey, right? And you count here on the table. As soon as you do that, you recollect your bees as well, and you start over and over again. It's up to 5 rounds, depending on the number of players, 4, 5, or 6 rounds. And the target is to have as many points, but to end in time. You might have people that work more strategically, mm-hmm. right? That take longer for a single round, but make more points. But you also might to hurry up and do it faster, do less points per round, but you are faster at the end. It turned out that the game will, most of the time, be very tight at the end, right?
Yeah.
The funny thing is that you can also block other bees. If I have a single bee, for example, here, you can jump on me. And as soon as I do the counting, it doesn't count for me, right? If you do the counting, you recollect your bees and you free my bee as well. So a game lasts about 45 minutes. That's too much for today, I know that. But just to give you the essence of the game is that you have people who play on speed. They want to close the count as fast as possible. And some others play more strategically. They try to get onto the blossoms with a high nectar count and collect more points. But this doesn't work together, right? If you're strategically and you're not fast enough, you feel during the game that you need to hurry up. If you're just counting a very low number of points, but you're fast, you need to be careful because the others count less, but maybe triple of what you do. But you always see that. That's always visible on the scoreboard. So that's a great thing.
Yeah, I mean, that sounds like a pretty good balance that you're going to have a lot of different balance paths.
Yes, and from the concept as well, just the insights, right? We didn't put so much effort in the balance. It came automatically from the principle of the game.
Yeah.
That was the beauty. We were surprised as well, but it turned out to be great.
And I really appreciate that you managed to decorate all the little bees, including the little flag waving bee.
Yeah, in the Formula One, right?
I don't know what the name of the guy who does the flag wave, but there's the bee version of it. I'm sure that incurred a lot of bee puns.
Absolutely.
During playtesting as well.
Yeah, including a lot of honey, right? Because we needed something. Yeah, that's what it is. Maybe one last word on it. There's extensions. You have cards that give you some extra speed or slows down, or you play in the other way around. And you can also turn the game on the backside where you have additional features. which you see here. You have some holes, then you can go from one side to the others. You have rainbows that collect more points. Not to go into all the details, but it gives you
a lot of room
for improvement.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Well, if you guys want to check out a beautiful game, then you should check out Ambrosia, which is from Skellig Games. And Mark, thank you again.
Yes, and we want to employ you to do some more marketing for us. Thank you, Beth. It was great being here.